Shelby Hotel, and the porch is kind of precarious, but this is vacant. That even had a wheelchair ramp over there, but anyway, I'm gonna take a walk through here. It's just open. It's right next to Shelby Ironworks and Old Shelby Hotel. Is it haunted? I don't know. I can't answer. But this is a massive structure. Believe it or not, it is pretty solid in here. I don't know what all this junk is, but there's a room. Old plastered walls and the old slats. And then the wainscoting. And there's just a lot of rooms. This is just the downstairs. It's two-story. This is like a smaller version of this I grew up in. That little closet, fireplace. But this is really, really something. Of course, you know, everywhere you go, people do the graffiti business, and it's fine. Get out, it says, get out. No, I'm gonna wait. So we've got room after room. Each one, this is like the old house, one of the houses I grew up in as a kid in North Alabama. Pretty much a fireplace in every room. Yep. And I'm gonna walk in here and got a little structure next to it. Of course, there's no window in here. I just opened up. All right. Stepping on glass. There's all the old screens. All the old screens neatly stacked there, and the screens are just, I mean, they're like in perfect shape. It's amazing. I don't know what that's about. It's almost like somebody knocked the plaster off, like they were gonna at some point do some rehabilitation efforts. This has got more than one staircase. I'm gonna go up that staircase after a bit. But right now, I'm just going through these rooms. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Well, there's like 10, 12, or 13 rooms downstairs. There's the back staircase. And there's wainscoting in most of this. And then this is a big area. It's like maybe it used to be a kitchen or whatever. And that is nice wood. Wow, that's not bad. It's amazing how well built this structure is. Totally fascinating. But what is really fascinating to me, because these floors are very solid. I was concerned when I first came in. That is nice. That wainscoting, all this is very solid. Of course, you have issues with the ceiling up there. I don't know what this used to be here. So are there any room? I'm gonna look up the history of this so that I can do some voiceover at some point to give the history of this. Is this supposed to be a haunted place? I cannot tell you that. There is, I think it's called Shelby Ironworks. I may go do a little video over there. There's a building right there. Which I may walk around there too. Exploring the unexplored. There's the old twin bed. We've got an old freezer. This is kind of like a little back porch area. And this, believe it or not, had kind of a wraparound deck that's totally falling apart. Still, that woodwork is interesting, but there's no way to walk out there. Somebody's shooting out in the country. And the bathroom. that has a big hole in the floor and a toilet. And then, so anyway, I'm going to find out the history of this place. I'll step back here. See if there's any rumors of hauntings or whatever. Who knows? And there's the rest of that. Oh, deck, I'm stepping on glass. But there is the rest of that deck. Another toilet out there. And a lot of this wood is pretty solid inside. The other that's been exposed to the weather is the only rotted. These floors in here are just as solid as they can be. Big old well-built structure. This has, and there's several of these in here, old church pews in some of these rooms. And the remnants of this, those old wood doors, huh? Fascinating. Yep, this brings back a lot of memories in a smaller version of this, what I partially grew up in Alabama. So, all right, I think this is the stairway. So let's go see where this goes. Well, no, it goes upstairs. Wainscoting.
That was very solid. There's one room tall.
And so they got the plaster off the all the walls downstairs, but not upstairs. The whole plaster is still here. Every one of these rooms has its own fireplace. Turn around. But you know, there's some ceiling damage, but there's no indication of any rotted wood inside this thing. It seems like a pretty, of course it would be very massive, but there's plaster on this wall here. Wainscoting all the way through it, except in these rooms. The old plaster on all the walls upstairs. Boy, do I remember when I was a kid having to bang plaster off these slats of walls in older houses. But it looks like downstairs they actually started, there's the back stairway, to do some stuff. There's some of the ceiling stuff there. Massive, massive. I remember the old window fans there. Yeah. But you know what? The wiring in this house, but at least for the most part, what I'm seeing, the wiring actually was updated at some point. So I don't know how long this has been sitting like this, but it's got up-to-date wiring. It's, here we go. This is just, I couldn't even begin to tell you the square footage, but it's got to have 20 to 26 rooms. I think I've counted 4 or 5 bathrooms in here so far. Like I said, the wiring is clearly updated. The downstairs, all the plaster's been removed from the walls. Upstairs, whole different story. This is newer wood here. Somebody's knocked this off, but at some point there was newer wood framed in around here. Certainly looks like it. But this is just about as solid as you can get. It's just amazing. There's the bathroom. Look at that old sink. I don't want to fall through here. I guess this is a shower. Wow. Old shower was framed in there. And wow, okay, toilet needs a little rehab, but there you go. There's a little mixture of the old and the new in here. Absolutely. Okay, so the shower is private from the toilet and sink in there. be interesting. I'm going to do a little research, like I said, to see how this, where this takes me as far as history. Well, there was a TV in here and somebody smashed it. I've always got kids doing crazy things. The ceiling is falling through on there, but as interesting as it is, as much as the looks like moisture got up there, the floors are just solid. And this is the second story. And I haven't found any weak spots in these floors at all. Nice big rooms. Now here's one that the plaster has been removed from all the walls. And wow. These front rooms are nice sized. This one, the ceiling, all the plaster been removed. It's like at some point somebody started to rehab this thing. A lot of freaking work. This door's been banged out. I am not going to step out on this structure. This is a little over the front porch kind of a thing here, and I'm just gonna leave that be. Okay. Old Shelby Hotel. And massive structure, I don't know, square footage, I'll just really be taking a wild guess. It could be 4,000 to 5,000 square feet, 3,000 to 5,000. Let's look at this, look at that, solid. Okay, let's creep down the stairs. And like I said, it's amazing how solid the plaster structure has been removed on these walls. Of course, as typical, kids or whoever have banged out the windows. But all those screens, I couldn't believe, were stacked in there. It's like brand new screens in them. Okay, I'm going to get outside and carefully walk across that porch and do some outside looking around, so I'll be back here. For the sake of, here is the outside of the old Shelby Hotel, I guess it's called. And I'm gonna walk down here. We got a little bit of a structure, but there's accessible ramp for a wheelchair ramp here. And then we got whatever this structure is over here. Then I'm going to pull around the car that other side where that other nifty little thing is. Okay, so this has been looked at several times because this is really beaten down path. So there's nothing new about what I'm doing here, but look at the size of this structure. You see that? Do you see that? Yeah, okay. I'm not gonna attempt to go in this one. I walk around, but that had electricity. It's got an old meter on it. It was wired up. In fact, the wire still goes to the street there. Okay, let's keep snooping around here. I imagine that this has been a spot of a lot of urban legends for Shelby, Alabama. Fascinating to say the least. Okay, I don't know what. I don't know. Let's see. Get the spider webs in my face. And it looks like tin off a roof. Okay. Investigating. All right. Well, this is almost like you can get in here. Okay. Oh, look. Too bad. I don't know. I don't want to hurt myself. I don't know. It's kind of excited. I don't want to go right now. That sheet metal could really hurt me if that fell. So I'm gonna go back to the vehicle and pull around to the other side because there's another building right next to the other side that I can get off the main road to get to. Building by the old Shelby Hotel. Massive structure. I'm just guessing. 6,000 square feet.